Hello, my name is Inda Melinda Sari, and I'm Registered Migration Agent in Wonderland Consulting Australia. How are you today? I hope you are well in these unprecedented times. As you may know, Australian immigration rules keep changing all the time, which affect visa applications. To keep up to date with all the latest immigration news, please subscribe to our channel by clicking on the logo in the right-hand corner and click subscribe. One of the new changes that has just been announced as one of the COVID-19 concessions is changes to the requirement and regulations of the employer-sponsored TR visa holders. Since there are many visas that fall under this category, we will do a quick explanation of all the different employer-sponsored visa. The first one is the temporary skill shortage or visa 4A2. Visa subclass 4A2 or temporary skill shortage visa is a temporary visa that lets an employer sponsor a skilled worker to fill a position when the employer cannot find an experienced Australian or permanent resident to fill it in. If you want to apply for this visa, you must be nominated for a skilled position by an approved employer who will be your sponsor. You also must have the right skills for the nominated job and meet the English language requirements. This visa has three streams, namely short-term stream, medium-term stream, labor agreement stream, which allows you to stay and work temporarily, and different streams have different durations in Australia. Okay, so the second one is the visa 457. So this is a temporary work skill visa, and this is a temporary visa that allows skilled workers to live and work for an approved business temporarily in Australia. Starting from 18th of April 2017, this visa is replaced by TSS, the subclass 4A2 visa, which will support businesses in addressing genuine skill shortages. There's a visa subclass 187, and this is a regional sponsored migration scheme visa that allows skilled workers to live and work in regional Australia permanently. The skilled workers must be less than 45 years old and nominated by an approved Australian employer in regional Australia. There are some requirements that the skilled workers must meet, such as skills, qualification, and English language requirements. Visa 187 has two streams, namely direct entry stream and temporary resident transition stream. And this visa is closed to new applications at the moment. There's a visa subclass 186, which is an employer nomination scheme visa. And this visa also allows skilled workers to live and work in Australia permanently. The skilled workers must have the necessary skills for their job, and Australian employer must nominate them as well. The difference between visa 187 and 186 is that visa 187 is for employment to be carried out in regional areas in Australia, while visa 186 is not. Visa 186 has three streams, namely direct entry stream, labor agreement, and temporary resident transition stream. The details of the concessions or the regulation changes for 2020-2021 that are going to impact visa 482 TSS, 457, and 186 employer nomination scheme are as follows. Reduced working hours, COVID-19 concessions. Usually, if you had unpaid leave, your eligibility for a permanent residency application through 186 visa not be met, or you may have to delay your plans to apply for one. The situation will especially worsen if you have been stood down or had your hours reduced due to the COVID-19 pandemic. If any of the scenarios apply to you, your concerns have been addressed as the government amends the instrument and implements transitional operation of Regulation 5.19 for certain 457 visa holders, which also will affect visa 482. The regulation might not lead visa 482 or 457 holders to permanent residency application sooner, but it helps the permanent residency applicants who already meet the requirement 2 or 3 years before the pandemic occurred. Besides, the new regulation brings two new definitions as well, as coronavirus reduced work period. This period is applicable for Visa 482 holders who are affected by COVID-19 and had their hours reduced. This period is defined as a period that occurred during the concession period within 4 years before Visa 186 application is made. And during this period, the employee must be employed under Visa 482 on a full-time basis job, or the time period of the work might change to be part-time basis job because the employee is on an unpaid leave due to the COVID-19. B, coronavirus unpaid leave period. This period is defined as a period that occurs during the concessions period and within 4 years before Visa 186 is made. And during this period, the employee must be employed under Visa 482 on a full-time basis. Regarding the higher income threshold and age exemptions, according to the LIN 20189, you might be still be eligible for the age exemptions even though you do not meet the Fair Work High Income Threshold income due to the COVID-19. Specifically, the concessions will not consider your working weeks that were impacted by COVID-19 pandemic from the FWHIT concessions amount. Your working weeks are affected by COVID-19 if you have to reduce your working hours, work part-time, unable to work full-time, stand down or take a pay cut. However, the Department of Home Affairs may apply a pro rata income threshold regarding the situation, which includes in the last 3 years before your visa application, you must hold Visa 482 while being employed by an employer who made the nomination, and you were in the nominated application related to your visa application. Your income must be equal to or greater than the high income threshold as applying at the end of the year, and pro rata threshold exclude any income when your employment was affected by COVID-19 pandemic. The concessions regarding COVID-19 pandemic will apply to the applications made on or after the 1st of February 2020, but before the 24th of November. It is also applicable to applications made on or after the 24th of November 2020. The COVID-19 concessions for Visa 482 and 457 holders seems to be benefit those who want to apply for Visa 186. Along with the COVID-19 concessions, the Visa 482 or 457 holders who have applied or fulfilled the 2 or 3 years requirement of full-time work do not need to worry about the possibility of delaying the Visa 186, the RT stream application process. These visa holders are also still eligible for the age exemptions even though they have not met the Fair Work High Income Threshold due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Hence, there is still a chance for Visa 482 and 457 holders to get a permanent residency through Visa 186 or 187 TRT during COVID-19 pandemic. The new regulation for Visa 186 and 187 requirements is aimed to alleviate the visa holder's burden during the COVID-19 pandemic. Along with the new regulation, it is hoped that the temporary sponsored workers can continue their plan with their employers. Besides that, the Department of Home Affairs Australia realized that the current situation is outside the temporary working visa holder's control. If you're currently a 457 or a 457 visa holder that want to know how the concessions can help you on your path to permanent residency, or you have any questions on how these changes can affect you, Wonderland Consulting is here to help you with any questions you may have. We specialize in complex visa cases, and as a registered Australian Migration Agent with the Migration Agents Registration Authority, OMARA, we are regulated in our professional practice and bound by the profession's code of conduct issued by MARA. Take the first step and get in contact with us. We are experienced, trustworthy, and we seek to deliver results. And most importantly, we are here to help you. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to our channel or visit our website for the latest news and helpful information.